the block diagram of the analog communication system, we have seen that the transfer of the information bearing signal can be done after performing modulation or no modulation at all on the information bearing signal. In this lecture of analog communication, we will understand what is modulation and what is the importance of modulation. Now, think of a situation when a person is outside his house and he wants to travel to a distant place. He can go there by bus or by a car or by aeroplane, or he can simply walk there. Transports carry him so that he can travel easily rather than walking and reach his destination safely. Modulation in the communication system is also done for the same purpose, to transfer the signal safely from sender to receiver. Modulation allows us to send a signal having low frequencies over a bandpass frequency range so that signal gets less affected by noise or distortion during the transmission. So what is modulation? Modulation is defined as the process by which some characteristics such as amplitude, phase and frequency, etc. of a carrier signal is varied in accordance with an information varying signal or modulating signal. Modulation process contains message signal or modulating signal, carrier signal and modulated signal. Message signal or modulating signal. The signal which contains information or message to be transmitted is called a message signal or modulating signal. It is a baseband signal. A baseband signal or a low-pass signal is a signal that includes frequencies that are very close to zero. It has to undergo the process of modulation to get transmitted. Hence, it is also called modulating signal. Carrier signal. The signal which has a certain amplitude, frequency and phase but contains no information is called carrier signal. It is an empty signal. It is used to carry the modulating signal or message signal to the receiver after modulation. Modulated signal. The resultant signal after the process of modulation is called modulated signal. This signal is a combination of modulating signal and carrier signal. Generally, the information bearing signal or message signal is a low frequency signal, and the low frequency signal cannot be used for the distant communication. This low frequency signal needs to be converted to a high frequency signal before transmission through the channel. Let's take voice signal for example. The frequency of the voice signal is nearly about 3 kHz. Highest audible frequency of a human is up to 20 kHz. The voice signal is a baseband signal, and due to the low frequency, this signal cannot be transmitted directly. But with the help of high frequency carrier signal, we can easily transmit this low frequency voice signal by imposing this low frequency voice signal in a high frequency carrier signal. And this process is simply known as the modulation of information bearing signal or message signal. So what are the advantages of modulation? Advantages of modulation. Modulation reduces the size of the antenna. Modulation increases communication range. It helps in multiplexing of the signal. Improves reception quality. Due to the modulation, power radiated from antenna will be less. By performing modulation, mixing of the signals can be avoided. And it also creates the possibility of bandwidth adjustments. Let's see how the modulation provides these advantages. Reduction in the size of the antenna. Let's say a signal is traveling in the space with the velocity of light having the frequency of 30 kHz and wavelength lambda. Let's say the size of the antenna L is equal to lambda by 5. The relationship between the frequency and the wavelength of a signal traveling in space can be given by the following expression. Velocity V is equal to frequency F into wavelength lambda, where V is the speed of the signal, which is similar to speed of light, which is equal to C. F is the frequency of the transmitted signal and lambda is the wavelength of the transmitted signal. Here, F is given as 30 kHz, or F is equal to 30 into 10 to the power 3. And wavelength of the transmitted signal. Lambda is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 30 into 10 to the power 3, which is equal to 10,000 meter. Now, the size of the antenna L is equal to lambda by 5, which is equal to 10,000 by 5 or 2,000 meter. Now, the required size of the antenna is 2000 meter, which is practically not possible to achieve because it is highly costly and cannot sustain the natural atmospheric condition. Instead of taking frequency F is equal to 30 kHz, let's take the signal frequency F is equal to 30 MHz. Then lambda is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 30 into 10 to the power 6, which is equal to 10. Then size of the antenna L is equal to 10 by 5, which is equal to 2 meter. This size of the antenna is achievable. So as we can see, the size of the antenna is inversely proportional to the frequency. The reduction in the antenna size can be done by increasing the frequency. The increase or decrease in the frequency can be done easily with the help of modulation. So this is one of the important reasons for modulation. Increasing the frequency range. The frequency of the baseband signal or message signal is low, and the low frequency signal cannot travel long distance when they are transmitted because they are heavily attenuated by noise. So the receiver on the other side of the channel will receive a signal which is heavily attenuated by noise. The attenuation reduces with the increase in frequency of the transmitted signal. The modulation process increases the frequency of the signal to be transmitted. By increasing the frequency of the signal can be transmitted over long distance without getting attenuated by the noise, or simply the range of communication can be increased. Therefore, modulation helps to increase the range of communication. Multiplexing of the signals. Multiplexing is a process in which two or more signals can be transmitted over the same communication channel simultaneously. It is not practically possible to distinguish between the different signals when transmitted simultaneously through a single antenna, as all of them lie in the same spectral range. If the analog signals are multiplexed, then it is called analog multiplexing. Similarly, if the digital signals are multiplexed, then it is called digital multiplexing. The process of multiplexing actually divides a communication channel into several number of logical channels, allotting each one for a different message signal or a data stream to be transferred. The device that does the multiplexing is known as multiplexer or mux. The reverse process of extracting the number of channels from one is done at the receiver is called demultiplexing. The device that does the demultiplexing is known as demultiplexer or demux. Due to the multiplexing, although signals will use the same channel, but every signal will have different frequency. So this is possible only with modulation. Modulation allows multiplexing, which enables the same channel to be used by many signals. Hence, many TV channels can use the same frequency range without getting mixed with each other, or different frequency channels can be transmitted at the same time. Improving the quality of reception. Using analog modulation techniques like frequency modulation, digital modulation techniques such as pulse code modulation or PCM, the effect of noise can be reduced to a great extent. Less effect of noise means better quality of the transmitted signal. The less effect of noise is achieved with the help of modulation techniques. So we can say that modulation techniques improves the quality of reception. Less radiated power from the antenna. Power radiated by antenna used in the communication system is proportional to L divided by lambda whole square, where L is the height of the antenna and signal is transmitted through the antenna, where lambda is the wavelength of the signal. According to this relationship, if the transmitted signals have a low frequency and high wavelength, then the radiated power by the antenna is very low and the signal will vanish after traveling some distance. That's why we need the modulation in order to change the frequency and the wavelength of the signal so that it does not get distorted and vanished after traveling some distance. Avoidance of mixing of the signal. Let's say baseband signals are transmitted without using modulation. These signals are transmitted by using more than one transmitter. Then all the transmitted signal will be in the same frequency ranging from 0 to 20 kHz. Therefore, there is a definite chance of all the signals getting mixed together. When this happens, receiver on the other side of the channel cannot separate the received signals from each other. In order to avoid that, each baseband sound signal can be used to modulate a different carrier. By doing this, the modulated signals will occupy different slots in the frequency domain, or we can say they will occupy different channels. Now, after doing that, if we transmit the signals, then mixing of the signals can be avoided and the receiver will be able to differentiate among the received signals. Bandwidth adjustment. Bandwidth is the difference between the upper and lower frequencies in a continuous band of frequency. If the signal has a higher frequency equal to FH and a lower frequency equal to FL, then the bandwidth of the signal can be given by BH is equal to FH minus FL. Using the modulation, we can change the higher and lower frequency of the signal, thus the bandwidth of the signal. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.